What's up, traders? Matt from the Trade Brigade here doing a technical analysis on ticker symbol BKKT for Bakkt Holdings. On the left-hand side, we have the daily time frame, and on the right-hand side, the 30-minute intraday time frame. First things first, this will, of course, be an update. We talked about it just yesterday, and the main thing to point out is the daily candle that ended up printing. Okay, so large inverted hammer basically indicating some selling pressure was coming in at these highs at and around $50. Now, before we just totally panic about what this stock could potentially do, think about what's already happened, okay? We've come from, let's just talk in terms of rough numbers here. Let's call it 20. We've now spent our some time up around 50, okay? So more than a double of the stock's price in a very short period of time. 1, 2, 3, 4 days to double your money here inside of BKKT. Would it not at least be reasonable to expect that some people who got in down here with good trade location are taking some profits up there at the highs? Yes, completely reasonable to think in, you know, along those lines. So again, don't forget that this stock has still been incredible in terms of, you know, relative strength across the marketplace, and a little bit of pullback into the end of the day, it's not the end of the world. Now, this does bring into play the next couple of points which we discussed in last night's video. The first one, and actually they're sort of tying into each other as of right now, the first one would be, or sort of, again, they're tying in at $30.50 or the support trend line, right? This general area should start to offer some support here inside of Bakkt Holdings. Why is that? Well, we certainly have a horizontal area. So think about it like this. Anyone who is long in here wants to defend their position. They're buyers, right? On the back test, you get a break, retest, and maybe use that as the next higher low. We also, again, have the support trend line, which would indicate that we could get another higher low at and around this general area. So for me, the all eyes on level is $30.50, basically around this area. If we come in and we start printing things that look like this, so a hammer candle, if we start printing indecision dojis, basically things that make us question, is the pullback ending? Can we flip long over these highs and then get back into these upside targets? That is the area where it could potentially unfold. Please be careful underneath 30.50, noting that there's about a $10, let's just call it $9, $10 to the downside until the next major support comes into play at $21, okay? So it's either you're correct about the trade here, in which case you go higher, or stop loss has to go here, right out if you're wrong, and avoid this move to the downside, basically taking us inside of this prior range from there on the daily time frame chart. So that's how I'm thinking about Bakkt. If it wants to come into this area, I'm looking at that as a gift, right? This is basically going to be a pullback, which could potentially be buyable on tight risk. Again, stop goes under the low of whatever, you know, it could be a pattern, could be a candle, goes underneath the low. Potential reward is back up here towards the highs at and around, let's call it 40, 45, somewhere in that general area if it wants to go on another run. Obviously, for upside, you would need to see supporting volume come in if it's going to be a momentum style play. That's really what I wanted to bring to light here, the fact that the pullback is not the end of the world. We have a known area of support where a potential pullback buy could be in store. That's going to wrap up the video. If you enjoyed it or learned anything new, let me know in the comments section or by giving the video a thumbs up. Don't forget our main channel is linked in the description. And all of that being said, I wish you a great Green Trading Week.